Few weeks ago, I bought those Rukka Step Shoes for my dogs because I really needed boots. But while looking for some dog boots, I realized that there are so many different like models out there, but not nearly enough information about them. And I had such a terrible choice overload that I thought, well, at least I'll review those and do my contribution to this issue. So maybe you find it a bit more easier to find the dog shoe model that fits you. Those are Rukka Step Shoes. They are a shorter type of dog boot. They come with a Velcro closure and also with a zipper closure that supposedly makes them easier to put on and off. Although I have lots of opinions about the zippers, but let's talk about that later. And they come with four boots in the package. That's really nice because often the dog boots are sold in pairs, in twos. And they also have this really, really nice bag in the complex. I really liked it because it makes way easier to store those. Those boots come in 8 different sizes, so you'll find whatever size your dog really needs. And the price is under 30 euros, which is actually really, really good for quality dog boots. This video is in no way sponsored or supported by Rukka. I bought those shoes myself because my dogs needed some shoes. So if you could like this video, that would be a very, very nice positive reward for me, because you know, the most important question about any dog boots is, do they stay on? And the answer for this particular model is yes, but. Like if your dog is walking only on the pavement or very like smooth surfaces, yes, they have no problem with staying on. But as soon as your dog steps into deeper snow, the snow pulls them off. That's the thing about those shoes. They are not meant to be used for wading in a deeper snow. But then again, the manufacturer already warns you about that. They say that those shoes are meant for walking on like a harsher gravel or on pavement, but those are not really meant to be walking in deep snow, and that's what also I experienced. But like, I'm not mad about that because I got those with a sole express to simply teach my dogs to walk in the boots, and you can check out that vlog that I did about training my dogs to walk in the boots. On my Instagram account stories, I asked you guys what are your questions about this particular model, and the question that I received the most is about fit, like how true is the sizing that the manufacturer provides and how well do they fit your dog. And so my experience with the manufacturer sizing is that they fit really, really nicely. But if your dog is in between sizes, as Lamora was, like I couldn't decide between size 6 and 7 for him. My experience is that you should go with a smaller size, not with a bigger size. I went with a bigger one, and at some point it felt like those shoes are slightly bit too big for him. However, for Mio, who was perfectly in the middle of that size chart, she has size 3 for her. Those shoes fit absolutely perfectly and she had no issues with the fit. I'd say you should really trust the manufacturer's size chart. They provide a very, very nice chart that's both in centimeters and inches, and you can very easily decide what size do your dog need. Next question, how easy are they to put on? And this is the part where I have a little bit of gripe with those boots, because, well, those zippers, like, they are meant to make the putting on and off easier, but in reality they actually make it a bit harder, especially for Mio's size. They are tiny, and at first when my dogs weren't exactly used to putting boots on, it took so much time because my dogs aren't understanding what's going on. They're holding their paws limply and just watching, what are you doing with that? And so it wasn't really easy at first. And also, if snow gets into the zipper, it gets really, really hard to open it. But then again, once I actually got used to putting them on, and once my dogs got used to putting them on, it got quite a lot easier. So I'd say that it's just a huge learning curve. You have to get over that, and then those boots are fine. And I actually found out that it's way easier to put them on if you get your dog not to hold his paw in air, like limply, just like that. But if you get your dog to step down, like what I would do is I would put on opened shoe, then I'd like put the dog's paw on the ground and then I would close it, and that made it way easier and way faster. So let's talk about how do you find out what size your dog is, how do you actually measure his paw. And I decided that the easiest way would be to take a simple paper and pen. I asked my dog to step on the paper, and then I simply drew an outline with the pen on the paper, and then I measured that outline, and it turned out to be a very, very precise way to do that. One of the questions that came up in my Instagram was about the soles of this boot, of those boots. Like, weren't my dogs bothered by the fact that those soles are stiffer? And so they are made from rubber, they are quite stiff, they are not like leather or anything, they move like this. And the answer is no, my dogs had absolutely no problems with that, and I don't believe there should be any problems with stiffer soles. I don't think that makes any much difference of walking in them. I don't think that my dogs would get easier used to like softer soles than those. And also I think that those stiffer soles actually provide better protection against environment. So if the manufacturer has already said that those boots are not meant to be used in like heavy snow, why did I choose those? Well, first, I didn't expect to have any amount of snow anytime, because I've already used to not having any winters, but well, now we are having this amazing winter wonderland. But also, as I mentioned, like my main purpose for getting those boots was to train my dogs, and so I looked for shoes that have a better price. Like all four boots for less than 30 euros is a very, very good price for a dog boots. That's on the lower end. But also I really trust the Rukka brand. I think they have quality products, so I didn't expect any problems, and I didn't have any problems with those shoes. And also I preferred the fact that they have all four boots in one package. I don't know, I didn't want to get the packages that are two boots and then two boots. I just wanted to get four boots in one package. But then again, now that I think about it, well, some dogs might have very different sizes on their rear paws and their hind paws, so maybe for those people better choice would be boots that come in twos. But for me, this was a perfect choice and I really liked them. And actually, I'll keep those boots for my dogs to walk on the pavement, like when there's salted pavement, but they're not wading in the snow. And also maybe if we need to walk in very hot summer, when there's really hot pavement, like, you know, when they have to walk on a really hot asphalt, then I think that those shoes would actually be really good for that. I have not tested them because I have had those boots only for a few weeks now, but my feeling is that those would be really good on hot pavements if we ever need them. And there's a like stiffer sole would provide even more protection against heat, and that's really nice. Now there still stays the problem that those boots can't be worn in deeper snow, so I need to find another model for my dogs. And there are two things that I would be looking at right now with the mindset now that I know that I have tested the first boots. I would definitely look for longer boots that go over their elbow. Are they called elbows on dogs? I don't know, sorry. Or actually, on my previous YouTube video, I received a very thoughtful comment about those issues, and Andrew suggested looking at the dog gaiters. I don't know how to pronounce that, sorry. So basically the idea is that there is a boot together with a leg covering, and then it closes behind the dog's back. That would be a really interesting idea to look into. So that's the future that I'll be looking into, because my dogs still would need something for deeper snow situations. On my vlog where I were training my dogs to walk in those shoes, I received a very thoughtful comment from Andrew, and he was asking like, am I worried about those shoes putting too much stress on my dog's paws, or about any ligament injuries due to wearing those shoes? I can't say I have a very clear answer to that. I'm not too worried about that. Veterinarians really often suggest wearing dog boots when the environment demands that. But also I could really look into that issue, and if you would be interested for me to do some research and make a video about this particular issue, like how do dog boots impact a dog's legs. Please let me know in the comments, like I don't know if you would be interested in something like that. If you would be interested too, that might be a really fun video to make, and I'm all up for that. In conclusion, I'd say those are really nice dog boots for city use. If you don't need to go wading in any deep snow, those would be perfect for your dogs. The quality is really nice. I really like the price and quality combo. Honestly, I didn't even expect to receive such a quality item for that price, so I'm really, really happy with those. And if that's your use case, I'd say those are a really good option. Thank you for watching this video till the end. And if you would like to reinforce my video of making habits, please like this video, and I'll see you next week.